These selfish elements are really important to know about because they play a major role in many aspects of modern biology. Transposons and viruses are actually important for genetic engineering and may eventually prove very valuable for gene therapy. Remember that we had the restriction enzyme that is the mechanism whereby bacteria fight viral infection. And what these restriction enzymes do is they look for particular sequences in the DNA of the virus and they chop the whole molecule right there. Now, DNA hates being separated from its complementary partners. And so where the restriction enzyme has chopped the viral DNA, the ends want to find something to latch onto. So they're called sticky ends. Now, if we deliberately play around with these selfish elements, we can use that stickiness in order to do something really kind of interesting. Let's go back to the bacterial plasmids. Remember, they also can insert themselves into the genome of the big chromosome of the bacteria. Now, if we play around with the plasmids and chop them a bit, and we have in a flask with them a segment of DNA from a different organism that we're interested in, we can get the following crazy thing happening. The restriction enzyme will chop out a bit of the plasmid. So now it's got sticky ends on either end, and we've got the DNA from some other organism that we're interested in. And by chance, with billions and billions of these in a flask, every now and then there will be some that line up with a particular region of DNA from a different organism that's now in the plasmid. And it'll be carried along. And so if this wants to go into a chromosome of a bacteria, it'll take it into the chromosome. So if you take this modified plasmid and you infect your target bacteria, then you can use that to insert like a human gene into the bacterial chromosome. And then you can breed up the bacteria that have this human chromosome in it. And as there's transcription, translation, you get protein product, and you can manufacture human proteins in a bacteria. And so, for example, this is now being used to manufacture human insulin, human growth factor. Human growth factor is a hormone that has very powerful consequences and is very important for therapy of children with certain growing disorders. But it can also be used by athletes who want to extend their longevity on the field. These were incredibly expensive before genetic engineering, but once you get the bacteria to grow it for you, it's just like growing anything else that requires rapid bacterial growth. So, viruses we can also try to harness because they're so good at penetrating human organism or any other host that we can again insert something into the viral genome and try to get it into a host. And so there are plans to do gene therapy for hemophilia, which has got that mutation that prevents blood from clotting properly. And if you have a donor DNA that will ensure healthy clotting of the blood, insert that into the genome of a virus, and then have the virus infect host cells that could again integrate a healthy gene into a host cell, getting the necessary product, the protein that's necessary for healthy blood. And so far, this is in the very early phases, and there's a lot of different ideas about how to approach this kind of viral vector. Here's one illustrated that uses a DNA virus that's very similar to the common cold. And in this particular virus, it does not integrate itself into the host chromosome like HIV does. It just takes the genetic material of the virus and keeps it inside of a cell. But once it's inside the cell, then you get the transcription of the viral DNA into proteins. And so you could bring in a vector that will do the work for you, infecting the cells, getting into places it wants. It goes into the cell. It releases its DNA, and then there's transcription, and it makes the protein. And if it's a protein that you've put in there, then you can have a healthy protein inside the cell. So a lot of ideas are out there about how to do this kind of gene therapy. At the moment, people are most comfortable using a virus that will not integrate into the host cell. And so the gene will be there as long as the cell stays alive. So it's a fairly short-term therapy. So genetic engineering is an entire field of endeavors that is based on harnessing the selfishness of these plasmids and viruses to promote the production of beneficial proteins.